Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to talk about Pravastatin. What is this drug Pravastatin? The suffix statin indicates this drug is one of the anti-hyperlipidemic agent. These drugs are commonly known as statins, but the real suffix of these drugs is mainly the vastatin. So vastatin indicates they are anti-hyperlipidemic agents. These drugs can reduce the cholesterol deposition within the intima of blood vessels. So when the cholesterol levels are excessively increased, it can form a fibrous cap which is called atheroma. This atheroma is rich in oxidized cholesterol along with blood clotting and aggregation of platelets, which forms a dense fibrous cap that blocks the blood flow. So this atheroma leads to narrowing of blood vessels, resulting in atherosclerosis. This atherosclerosis may result in various cardiovascular complications, particularly it can produce myocardial infarction. Even it can increase the risk of stroke and other coronary artery diseases. That's why cholesterol level should be controlled thoroughly, and here pravastatin can reduce the cholesterol levels, thereby it can reduce the risk of atherosclerosis. This drug can reduce the total cholesterol levels within the body, as well as it can reduce the LDL cholesterol, which is considered as bad cholesterol. The LDL plays an important role in the formation of atherosclerosis, which is going to be reduced by pravastatin. Similarly, this drug can also increase the levels of HDL cholesterol, which is considered as good cholesterol. So this cholesterol is released from the tissue damage, which reduce the formation of atherosclerosis. And finally, it can also reduce the triglyceride levels. Along with reduction in cholesterol and triglyceride levels, pravastatin can also reduce ApoB factor, which increase the risk of atherosclerosis. By all of these actions, pravastatin acts as anti-hyperlipidemic agent. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of pravastatin. And here we can observe a carboxylic acid is attached to a 7-membered acyclic chain. So pravastatin is the heptanoic acid derivative. Now let us see how this drug acts. Within the liver, cholesterol is going to be biosynthesized from the mevalonate pathway. One of the important intermediate within this pathway is the HMG-CoA. This HMG-CoA is going to be converted into mevalonate by one of the enzyme HMG-CoA reductase. This enzyme produces rate determining step, so the total biosynthesis of cholesterol within the liver is controlled by HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. Now once this mevalonate is going to be formed, it is going to be converted into cholesterol by several steps. This is one source of cholesterol for the liver, but liver can also get the cholesterol from other sources, particularly from the circulating LDL cholesterol. The LDL cholesterol which is present in the blood can be taken into the liver through a specialized LDL receptors. When this LDL binds to this LDL receptors, it can be internalized. Now after internalization, again the LDL receptors are going to be transported to the membrane. Now lysosome can act on this LDL cholesterol. They can produce the digestion of this LDL cholesterol such that they can release the free cholesterol along with amino acids. In this way, these two are the two important sources for cholesterol within the liver. One is the biosynthesis and second one is the uptake of LDL cholesterol. So in this way, cholesterol is going to be present in the liver. Now pravastatin is one of the drugs which can block this HMG-CoA reductase enzyme so that it can inhibit the biosynthesis of cholesterol within the liver. And when this enzyme is inhibited, the cholesterol biosynthesis within the liver is going to be inhibited. Now liver is getting less cholesterol, which can be obtained from the circulating LDL cholesterol. Now the liver is going to express more number of LDL receptors, which can bring the LDL cholesterol into the liver. Now by binding of this LDL cholesterol to these receptors, the cholesterol can be internalized into the liver. This reduces the circulating LDL cholesterol levels within the blood, which reduces the risk of atherosclerosis. In this way, pravastatin can reduce the LDL cholesterol, thereby it can reduce the total cholesterol At the same time, it can also increase the HDL cholesterol. By all of these actions, it can reduce the risk of atherosclerosis. Now let us see the precautions of pravastatin. Just like the other statins, pravastatin can also produce its effect on the muscle and it can produce myopathy. So within the patients, we can observe increased muscle pain. And this muscle pain can also be diffused to the different parts of the body. Initially, the muscle pain can be observed at few locations, but it can be diffused. Similarly, this drug can also increase the levels of CPK, creatine phosphokinase levels, which again indicate the myopathy. So suppose these are the normal levels, they can be increased up to 10 times by use of pravastatin. In such cases, this drug should be stopped as these conditions indicate severe myopathy within the patients. Similarly, in the elders with age greater than 65 years or in the patients with any hyperthyroidism, this myopathy is more pronounced with the use of pravastatin. Similarly, this drug is going to be converted into metabolites by cytochrome P450 system. Among these, CYP3A4 is one of the major enzymes which is responsible for metabolism of pravastatin. We have few other drugs such as erythromycin, which is a macrolide antibiotic, cyclosporine, which is an immunosuppressant. These drugs are strong inhibitors of CYP3A4 enzyme. Thereby, they can increase the levels of pravastatin, which further increase the risk of myopathy. So, with these drugs, pravastatin should be carefully given as it increases the risk of myopathy. Similarly, fibrates like gemfibrozil can also produce the myopathy. So, when pravastatin is combined with this drug, it can further increase the risk of myopathy. So, this combination should be given in those patients where the benefits outweigh this adverse reaction. Similarly, this drug can also produce rhabdomyolysis, the dissolution of muscle fibers. This is more pronounced in the patients with renal failure. So, in such patients, we can observe increased precipitation of proteins resulting in the myoglobinuria. So, in such patients with severe renal failure, this drug is contraindicated. Similarly, this drug can increase the liver enzymes. So, it can increase the levels of ALT, alanine transaminase, AST, aspartate transaminase levels can be increased. So, suppose normal levels are like this, pravastatin can increase the liver enzymes up to 3 times, which indicates some hepatic insufficiency. So, when the liver enzymes are excessively increased greater than 3 times, then this drug should be carefully given. What are the side effects? This drug can produce few of the gastrointestinal side effects resulting in nausea and vomiting, diarrhea, and it can produce muscle pain, muscle tenderness, some dyspepsia. It can also produce some chest pain, dizziness, upper respiratory tract infections resulting in cough. It can also produce rashes, headache, pharyngitis, and fatigue can be observed with this pravastatin. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet form at different strengths starting from 10 mg to 80 mg. So, it is available as 10 mg, 20 mg, 40 mg and 80 mg. For the adults, the initial dose is given as 40 mg. Then the dose can be slowly increased up to 80 mg to control the LDL cholesterol. But in the adolescents with age 14 to 18 years, the initial dose is 40 mg. And it should not be given greater than 40 mg. But for children with age 8 to 13 years, the initial dose is 20 mg, which can be increased up to 40 mg based on the efficacy of the treatment. So that's about this drug pravastatin, which is a anti-hyperlipidemic agent. This drug reduces the total cholesterol levels, LDL cholesterol levels, triglycerides, and ApoB factor. And it also increases the HDL cholesterol levels. By all of these actions, it can reduce the risk of atherosclerosis and cardiovascular complications. But this drug can produce myopathy and rhabdomyolysis as the two important side effects. It can also increase the liver enzymes, particularly with the patients with renal failure. So that's about this drug, pravastatin. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.